What is going on, everybody? This is Soccer Junkie, and today I am bringing you the latest Premier League transfer news. Now, we start off with the crazy news from Spain. Reportedly, Real Madrid are interested in cashing in on their prize player, Gareth Bale. They want to load him off because they want to sign Eden Hazard from Chelsea. Doesn't make sense to me. I think Bale is better than Hazard at the moment. Let me know in the comments below who you think is the better player right now. But nevertheless, apparently, Manchester United would be interested in purchasing Gareth Bale for approximate fee of £90 million. God damn, that's a lot of money. I wish I had £90 million. Then I would be, oh my, I'll be settled. I'll be done, man. I'll be living life, you know, popping bottles at the club. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, enough with that bullshit. Now, seriously. Does this move make sense for Real Madrid? Do they need to sell him in order to fund their transfer for Eden Hazard? Like I said, I think Gareth Bale is better than Eden Hazard, in my opinion. So if I were Real Madrid, I would keep Gareth Bale and, you know, let Chelsea have Eden Hazard. Only way I see this move happening is if Chelsea agree to sell Eden Hazard to Real Madrid in advance, and Manchester United would agree with Real Madrid to purchase Gareth Bale in advance. Obviously, Gareth Bale would have to say yes, so is Eden Hazard. I'm sure Eden Hazard will say yes, but as far as Gareth Bale, I'm not so sure if he would want to come to Manchester United. I mean, obviously, Manchester United is a great club. Yeah, it is, but playing for Real Madrid, you know, at the moment, it's probably a better choice. I'm not gonna lie, it's probably a better choice. So, does he want to come back to England? I'm pretty sure Gareth Bale's family is satisfied living in Spain. I mean, honestly, the only way I see this move happening is if Real Madrid purchase Eden Hazard and then sell Gareth Bale to Manchester United. That's the only possibility. But to be honest, the chances of this moving are happening are very, very slim. I don't think this move will happen. Certainly not in January. And I doubt it's going to happen in the summer as well. And to be fair, Gareth Bale so far has been fantastic for Real Madrid. Eden Hazard has been okay for Chelsea. So I don't know if it makes sense for Real Madrid to purchase Eden Hazard, basically replace Bale with Hazard. It just doesn't make sense to me. But let me know in the comments below, who would you rather have if you were Real Madrid? Would you rather have Eden Hazard or would you rather have Gareth Bale? Also, let me know in the comments below, Manchester United fans, would you love to see Gareth Bale at Manchester United? Personally, I would. I mean, the guy is phenomenal, world-class player, one of the better players in the entire world. Absolutely fantastic. I would love to have a Welshman on this team. Now, moving on. Inter Milan are reportedly interested in loaning in Adnan Januzaj from Manchester United. Louis van Gaal said not that long ago that he is, you know, considering loaning out Adnan Januzaj. Personally, I'm not so sure if I agree with this move. Yes, Adnan Januzaj hasn't been featured for Manchester United that many times this season, but at the same time, he's a wonderful player and he can offer Manchester United a lot of things on the pitch, especially going forward. I think he's very skillful. He can definitely take on the defenders. He's got some pace. He's got some talent. And obviously, you don't want him to be sitting on the bench all the time. So it could make sense for Manchester United to loan him out to Inter Milan. On one hand, it would certainly make sense for Manchester United to loan him out, you know, get him more experience, get him playing more often. Because right now, at the moment, he's not really been featured in Louis van Gaal system. And honestly, when Di Maria comes back and other players come back, I don't think he will be featured that many times. So perhaps this could be a good move for both clubs. Let me know in the comments below, Manchester United fans and Inter Milan fans, would you want to see this move happen? Now, Manchester City are apparently considering launching a £47 million bid for a long time Manchester United target Mats Hummels from Borussia Dortmund. For me, this would be a great signing for Man City, you know, as they need some help on their defense. Mangala hasn't been very good so far this season, and De Michelis, you know, he's getting on, he's getting older. Kompany has been injured, so imagine having Kompany and Mats Hummels on one team. I mean, that's crazy good defense in my opinion. Now, can this move happen? Yeah, sure it can. I mean, just like any other move, really, if you really think about it. But do I see this move happening in January? Personally, I don't. I think Mats Hummels will stay at Borussia Dortmund for the remainder of the season, and maybe only he will move in the summer. That's the only possibility that I'm thinking of personally. Despite all the struggles of Borussia Dortmund, I think he's too loyal and he will stay at the club for at least the rest of the season. Now, according to reports in Italy, Tottenham Hotspur appear to be interested in Raul Albiol, a defender from Napoli, for a reported fee of £8 million. Now, for me, this makes sense for Tottenham on a couple of levels. One, they need to improve their defense. Yes, they have Vertonghen, but there are also rumors that they might lose him to Man City or another club or Liverpool. Having Raul Albiol on a team would make sense. So yeah, he would add some depth, you know, to the team, provide some help on the defensive side. Let's face it, Spurs need some defensive help as well. You know, they haven't been very good this season. Lately, they've been playing much better, but at the same time, you would expect the club like Spurs to be challenging for top four, which they're not at the moment. So this would make sense for him, for Tottenham Hotspur, just to add more depth to their defense. Liverpool appear to be in pole position to sign Konoplyanka from Dnipro, as Ukrainian side fearing that he may live on a free at the end of the season because he hasn't signed a contract extension. So he's going to move for sure, in my opinion. So they want to cash in and get some money for him. Now, does this move make sense for Liverpool? In some ways it does, in some ways it doesn't, because at the moment I believe Liverpool needs some defensive help. They need another center back. They need to replace Glenn Johnson. Konoplyanka is a good young player. You know, he's got a lot of potential. I've seen him play a couple of games, you know, mostly on the international level, and he has impressed me. I think he's gonna be quality. He's not gonna be one of those Arshavins. I mean, Arshavin, he basically wasted his talent at Arsenal. When he moved from Russia to Arsenal, he just wasted his talent. First season, he was okay, and after that, I don't know what happened. He's just terrible. I don't think that's going to be the case with Konoplyanka. I think if you give him, you know, support, teach him the ways of football in England, he can produce you a lot of good stuff. I think Konoplyanka could be good for Liverpool. So to me, it would make sense for them to sign him. It appears that Glenn Johnson agreed to join Roma after this season with Liverpool because he's not going to sign any contract extension, so he's going to live on a free to Roma. Liverpool are not losing anything here. I mean, they're not. Glenn Johnson, let's face it, he's a terrible defender. I still cannot believe he's actually was a starting right back for England. I mean, what? I mean, this just doesn't make sense to me whatsoever. Let me know in the comments below, Liverpool fans, how you feel about this move. Now, this has been your Premier League transfer news roundup. Let me know in the comments below, which move do you want to see happen? Do you, Manchester United fans, I'm sure you want to see Gareth Bale at Manchester United just like I do. Liverpool, what do you think about Konoplyanka? Tottenham Hotspur supporters, what do you think about Raul Albiol potentially joining your team? So let me know in the comments below. Make sure you guys hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. I appreciate all your support. Thank you for watching, and peace.